As NAIDOC Week celebrations get underway, the focus is also on the question of Indigenous recognition. Advocates are hoping for change. Now the country has its first Aboriginal Cabinet Minister in charge of Indigenous Affairs.
On the walls of Ken Wyatt's office hangs a portrait of one of his heroes. Neville Bonner was Australia's first Indigenous parliamentarian, someone Mr. Wyatt has closely followed, and now he's the Aboriginal Minister for Indigenous Australians.
I know my mum would be, she would have cried, and I suspect the old man would have as well. But it would have been tears of seeing a kid who lived in poverty make it into this place.
The minister is now tasked with finding a pathway to Indigenous recognition, a decades-long campaign.
We invite you to walk with us.
Both the Turnbull and Morrison governments had rejected enshrining an Indigenous voice in the Constitution, the key proposal from the 2017 Uluru Statement from the Heart. But the minister says the coalition is committed to bringing about change.
But when I have read back through the Statement from the Heart, what I see is an expression of Aboriginal people saying, fundamentally, listen to us, please.
The opposition says it's ready to work with the government.
It's up to the Prime Minister and Ken Wyatt to convince the members of their team that this is a very worthwhile thing to pursue. Bipartisanship does not mean a race to the bottom. It means we aspire for the highest possible point.
While both major parties have pledged to work together, it comes after decades of previous promises, and community advocates are hoping for meaningful change.
We need to get this right, because if a referendum falls over, you know, what does that say to our people? We'll never be at peace with ourselves if we can't work out the relationship that we have between us all.
Just how the coalition will address those calls remains unclear. Nikari Thorpe, SBS World News.
Well, we're very pleased that the Minister for Indigenous Australians, Ken Wyatt, joins us now from Canberra. Good evening to you, Minister. As the incoming Minister in this portfolio, do you support the Uluru Statement from the Heart for an Indigenous voice in Parliament?
Well, what we've got to first unpackage is what that voice is defined as, because over the years when I've heard our people use the voice, I've heard families say, listen to our voices. I've heard communities say, listen to our voices. And it is about governments listening at all levels to community and our people. But what that takes the shape of at a national level is still evolving. And certainly Prime Minister Morrison has made a strong commitment to constitutional recognition being achieved in the term of this government. And both he and the Leader of the Opposition have had discussions and have agreed that Linda and I will take forward some of that thinking that will influence our colleagues in this House.
Well, you've said there's a unique opportunity here for bipartisan cooperation, and you've said in the package there that you're committed to bringing about change. What is the minimum amount of change we can expect for this kind of recognition?
Well, I think the co-design will come up with what it is that we can have Australians agree on, because we have that triple test now. We have the majority of our people need to support it, the majority of Australians, but more importantly, the majority of states and territories. It's a high goalpost that's set for referenda, so we need to get it right. And what those few sets of words will be is going to be absolutely critical, and I've started having discussions with some of our leadership.
Minister, thank you so much for speaking to us tonight, and good luck with that process.
Thank you very much.